Hello! Today we are going to try our hands at making rain. We will complete the making rain experiment from Lesson 9 of the Weather and Water Science Unit from The Good and the Beautiful. In this unit, you have learned that there are three states of water: liquid, solid, and gas. Rain is a liquid, specifically liquid precipitation, water that falls from the sky. In this experiment, we will try to bottle our own personal little rain shower. Before we get started, turn to the Making Rain Experiment page in Lesson 9 of your student journal. Pause the video while you fill out the procedure section with the steps needed to perform this experiment. You can find these steps in your course book. All right, are you ready to begin? As you can see, I have gathered all the items needed for this experiment. A jar, hot water, blue food dye, a metal pie pan, ice cubes, and a clock or watch. Because hot water is involved, if you're following along and completing this experiment at home, it's a good idea to have an adult help you so you don't get burned. Okay, I'm going to start by slowly filling this jar a quarter of the way with hot water. For fun, I'll add some blue food dye. Food dye isn't necessary for this experiment, but it can make your rain a little more visible. Two or three drops will be plenty. Now I will take my pie pan and cover the opening of the jar. I'll set it face up so it's ready for the next step. Finally, I will take these ice cubes and fill the pie pan. Now, in your student journal, fill out the four conditions needed to create rain. You can find these in your course book. Be sure to write down the start time as well. If you're following along with me, you can mark the start time as 10 a.m. We will check back periodically to watch for rain. Do you see what I see? Let's observe our homemade water cycle and talk about what's happening. In order for it to rain, certain conditions have to be present: water, air, heat, and a source of cooling, in this case, the ice. Take a closer look. As the hot water evaporated, it increased the humidity within the jar. Once the ice was added, the warm, moist air immediately began to cool down. Since cold air can't hold as much moisture as warm air, the moisture condensed into tiny droplets, forming a little cloud. When the droplets became too heavy to withstand gravity, they started to fall and roll down the sides of the jar. This is the same way rain forms high up in the sky through a process called condensation. Through this cycle, rainwater will eventually make its way back into the sky through evaporation to repeat the process over and over again. Pretty amazing, isn't it? If you are completing this at home and don't see rain in your jar right away, don't worry. It could take several minutes for a reaction to occur, so try to be patient. It'll be worth it. For today's experiment, it started to rain at 10:18 a.m. That's 18 minutes. Don't forget to fill out the rest of the page in your student journal, including how long it took to create rain.